This video is brought to you by Squarespace, a platform perfect for creating your own website. Stay tuned to hear more.
Hello everyone, welcome to the vlog. My name is Tiffany, and today I want to take you guys on a really fun adventure because I am getting back into sketchbooking. It is officially time. I took a really long break from it because I didn't have a lot of time to do it in college, but ever since graduating, I've been trying to refocus my priorities, and one of them is practicing. I recently actually was talking to someone about my old sketchbook habits, and it just made me really miss it, and I felt really sad that like I'm not really that person anymore. I wanted to start off with a really simple sketchbook, so nothing too fancy. This is actually a really old Muji notebook that I have from, I don't know, years ago when I bought it, and I knew I would want it for some reason, but I never used it. It has a lot of paper, as you can see, and I've already gotten started on a little bit in the sketchbook, but I wanted to keep that part to myself because it felt very like private and I don't know, like strange that I was getting back into it. Like habits that I'm hoping will slowly come back to me, but they're not fully back yet, so I'm not completely confident in my skills. I wanted to do a fun self-portrait today. What better way to practice than doing some self-portraits? I haven't done that in a really long time. This is the sketchbook that I'm currently using for anyone who is curious. It's the Muji one. I don't know if they even sell this anymore, this exact brand, because like I said, I bought it years ago, but it has like, it's so dense and thick, so I'm really excited to be filling this up. One of the things I did want to do though is I wanted to go to the craft store right now and buy some new supplies because it has been so long that I actually don't have most of the supplies. I was digging through my old materials, and since college I've mostly been focusing on polymer clay and all of that good stuff. It's been a long time since I've done like traditional work after I started using Procreate. I'm really excited. We're gonna do a little haul, so I'm gonna run to Michael's right now and we're going to see what fun stuff they have. And my taste has really shifted since the last time I sketchbooked, and I'm very much a pink girly now, so I'm gonna be buying some fun pink materials today too, and I'm just so excited. I feel very happy. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and head over to Michael's, I guess.
Yes, the pink section. Wait, this is actually really cute. Maybe we get some pink jelly rolls?
This is a glitter highlighter. It has glitter in it.
I may or may not so far only be getting pink markers, but they're all just so cute and pretty.
I was originally testing out a bunch of these Tombow markers because I do have a set of Faber-Castells, but the skin tones in them are actually like horrendous. And I just found these that I feel like would be a good substitute. And they have like a 40% off coupon today, I think. So I think I'm gonna get this because it looks like, I don't know, it'd be pretty cute. I don't wanna use like my fancy Copics for sketching because I don't think that's necessary. So I think these are gonna be a good alternative. I'm going a little ham, but like I haven't had a reason to do this in so long, so I'm so excited. Markers and like art supplies excite me so much, so far this is the little section I got. I also got some pastels, but mostly as you can see I'm focusing on pink because first of all what I want to do today is pink, and second of all, although I try not to have like a theme in my sketchbooks, I've just been doing so much pink art lately that I feel like it makes sense to invest in some good pink markers. I'm excited. I feel like my marker selection has been holding me back for a bit, but now I'll be able to have everything I want. So I'm back, a little haul. I ended up only getting the Tombow brushes. I didn't want to go overboard, and I feel like this is fine. So I got this little set. I got it for 40% off. That was so exciting. And it's just like the portrait palette set. So this has like skin tones. And then I got a bunch of the pink ones. And these are buy one, get one 50. And I don't know what compelled them to have like these sales today because Black Friday's been over for a while. But I don't know, maybe they felt like being generous. I'm not gonna complain. Just got a bunch of different shades of pink. And then Lastly, kind of randomly, they had their beads on sale for 50% off, which normally it's like buy one, get one 50% off, which is actually 25% off everything, which is not that big of a deal. But 50% off is a lot. So I got these little pastel like square ones. And then I got two of these little pink stars. And these are like really nice quality pink stars. They're not like the plastic ones I typically use. I don't know when I'm gonna use these beads, but I will find a reason to, and then my stuff will look beautiful. But yeah, we have all the materials. We have some markers. I'll show you what else I've been using lately because I feel like that's important as well. Sorry, this is so tasty. Oh my god. Material girl. These are just mild liners in a little rainbow cup, but that's kind of irrelevant to be honest. I don't actually use those very often. My favorites are Faber-Castell's, and I used to live by these when I used to sketchbook. They're not all in here, but this is a new set because I haven't used them in years. Decided to buy a new set. These are kind of expensive. But you know what? If I want to get back into it, I need all the good materials. And so I got these. So I'm using those, and I'm just so excited to be starting this little sketchbook because I just haven't done it in so long. Oh, and I have a pink Copic that I wanted to use, so I have to go find that as well. I also have my, of course, drinky for the day. Today's drink is the cafe latte caramel macchiato, and this one is really, really good. I actually used to not really like this one when I was drinking them when I was younger, but ever since like kind of becoming an adult, it has a bit of a bitter aftertaste, and I just think it's like really, really good. Oh my gosh, literally so tasty. First thing I want to do is add some stickers to the front because I do have, I thought this would be cute if we just put this on the front. This is technically like the back, but it's also the front because the Muji stickers are all backwards because they're a Japanese brand. So the first thing I am going to do is stick one of these guys on there. And when I used to sketchbook, the first thing I would do is kind of break it in with stickers. And I used to make stickers at the time, but they were nowhere near as professional as the ones I make now. So it's just really cute to like see the growth. And so that is really nice and cute and holographic. This was actually a portrait that I did the other day and I don't really love it. And just to kind of warm up today, usually I just add to some old entries before I start, and I did this the other day. I kind of forgot that I have these little heart holographic stickers that totally fit with the vibe and the theme of this one. So I'm gonna just stick these kind of wherever I think they belong. I did this one the other day and it's not my best work, but it's one of my like first times back, and I did kind of make a mistake on this page, so I'm just gonna cover it with a sticker, and we will deal with that whenever we inevitably get to it. This is what this page is looking like. It was a really simple kind of sketch, but my eyes do not look great on this one, so we're just gonna ignore that and open up to a new page. I also want to replace this ribbon because as you can see it's red and I want to use a pink one, so we'll be doing that as well later. And so I haven't really cracked the spine on this one yet, but I'm going to need to. I don't think I have much else in here other than this, so we're gonna start off strong, but I think it's time we head to Michael's.
Today's little desk friends of choice, we have some sunny angels. As you can see, this one's our cream puff guy and he's so cute, but they're just chilling on my desk from my last video. Kind of talked about them briefly, so there they are. They kind of match. I don't know, I feel like all my stuff kind of has the same aesthetic, so it's really cute. Wow.
But before we start drawing, I have a few words from today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is a platform perfect for creating your own website, and I've used it to create both of my websites that I'm sure you guys are familiar with by now. My first website is my shop website, and Squarespace makes it so easy with their amazing templates and easy commerce tools, and they're the easiest to use and help you maximize your profits. You can shop my art at tiffany.com for cute little things, and I'll have that link down below if you want to check out my website. You can also make your portfolio online. As an illustrator, it's super helpful to have your portfolio online, and I have mine, and I will link this in the description box as well if you guys want to see recent work that I've been up to. And today we're going to try to mix this work with my realism. If you guys want to try out Squarespace for yourself, please head to squarespace.com/TiffanyWeng and use the code TiffanyWeng for a discount off your first purchase of a website or domain. Thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video, and now let's get back to the drawing.
Okay, so I think this is the best top-down view I'm gonna get, so hopefully it didn't come out too bad. So this is what I did, and it's like pretty much the real first portrait I ever did, but we're gonna try to practice some more today. And typically I like to just pick a random page in my sketchbook and I like to jump around because I think It's easier for me that way. I have found with using the sketchbook that it's a bit annoying because it's super like, do you see what I mean? Like bouncy, but hopefully as I break this in a little bit more, it'll become a little bit easier. I'm gonna use my phone and I'm just gonna look through like my camera roll and find pictures that I like. And today to sketch, I'm gonna be using this Zensations Zebra pink colored pencil. It's like a fancy color pencil, but since everything I'm drawing today is pink, I'm gonna be using this. And I'm just gonna be doing like a little collage kind of sketchbooky moment. I'm doing some guidelines and I know it's like so light you can't even see it, so I'm doing most of them off camera. I honestly haven't taken any like good photos of myself in a long time, so I'm using random like screenshots from Snapchat and I'm just gonna draw these out and then we're gonna start. So of course something goes wrong because I just can't film a video in one take without it being super difficult. So I don't like how this is coming out. I'm going to try it again on a separate piece of paper. We're gonna tape it over it. That's typically what I do when I mess up and I don't like how it looks. So we're gonna give it a second try and hopefully it turns out better this time, but we will see.
Today's show of choice while I'm drawing is The Nanny. I haven't watched that since I was really, really young, but I saw some clips of it on TikTok the other day and I decided I'm going to rewatch the whole series because I never really got through it and I love me some good sitcom background noise. I really wanted to have a chance to like kind of talk through my process, especially because it's been so long since I've done this. I was trying to draw like two separate portraits and they both just did not come out how I wanted them to. So we're doing a third attempt on a separate piece of paper, not in my sketchbook, so I can tape it over the two sketches I just did that look horrendous. And that's typically how I fix my mistakes in my sketchbooks. Although I think sketchbooks are a place where you shouldn't be afraid to make mistakes, I have a hard time living up to that standard sometimes, making things that I don't think look good. And so I still have to combat that part of my life where I want everything to look really nice and pretty. So sometimes I will cover my mistakes with other sketches, but I think the most important thing is to just not give up. So this is my third try of the night, but it's been so long since I've drawn in any realistic style, I'm trying to cut myself some slack. My camera actually died at one point, so I had to do some of the sketching off camera, but this is what I ended up with. I just took like a really awkward selfie earlier today and I decided to sketch it. And now that I've graduated and I am no longer under the impression that like realism art is the only type of good art, I have decided to kind of mix my influences and make little pink realistic sketches, add some Sailor Moon influence. That's something that I wouldn't have necessarily approved of the last time I was doing this style, but you know, a lot of things have changed since then. So as you guys have been seeing, I've been drawing everything out in pencil. I used to be able to just go in and do it all in pen, but I'm using pencil this time and I'm trying to find the right shade of pink. I'm just gonna do some light shading. I think shading is something that I'm still struggling with right now because it's just been so long since I've done it, and shading with marker is completely different than shading with pencils, and there's basically just like no forgiveness to it. So I'm still trying to find that confidence again, but I like to do this over my pencil sketches and typically it will smear a little bit of the pencil, so you just have to be a little bit careful of that. I try my best not to, but because I do my own makeup, I feel like it's a little bit easier to draw myself because it's kind of similar to how I put on my own makeup, which is kind of funny in a way. But I'm just gonna go through and color it, and I'm using only pinks today because I want to make something cute and pink, and I think it's turning out okay. I think my best way of doing it is starting off light and then going darker, and I'm just using these different shades of pink, and I basically used only the Tombow markers, which I've discovered I think are just really hard to use on the paper in the sketchbook, but that is okay. I will find a way around it. But this was all really fun for me. I think it's been a long time since sketching in this style has been fun for me. And that's something that I kind of like kept in mind as I was doing this, is that although it is for practice and I do want to get better at it, I also don't want this to become a chore. And if this is something that I want to practice, it's definitely going to have to be something that I enjoy or I'm not going to be able to keep up with it. I found that using markers to fill in your colors and your shades is a lot like painting, and you have to just kind of look at the bigger picture. So I'm trying to just block in the general shadows and areas that have more color or more contrast. And of course, I'm focusing on my eyes because I really really like my eye makeup, so that's something that I have a lot of fun with, is like drawing my lashes and stuff. And the next part of my process is I'm going to ink in the details with a micron. It's been so long, literally so long, since I've touched a micron that it felt so foreign to me, and I really did not enjoy that feeling. So I'm really excited to like get back into this and have everything feel familiar again. Unfortunately, my hand is blocking a lot of this footage, so I try to pick out the best parts where you can actually see what I was doing. I love drawing in my eyeliner when I draw myself because it's just like so much fun, and I think it's so cute. And so right now I'm doing my lashes, and I'm not doing my lashes quite like how they look IRL. I'm doing them just kind of like how I want them to look, which is a bit more of the stylized version. And if I could find fake lashes like this in the real world, I would, but I actually haven't found many that flatter my eye shape, which is why they don't look like this usually. I really do love inking though, and I think this is one of my favorite parts because it adds so much contrast, and like you can really add your own style to this part. And I just really enjoy having this time to like refine my art. I think rendering is also one of my favorite parts, just like making things look finished and nice. So I'm going through, and you can see I do have a little bit of like hesitancy, is that a word, hesitancy with my pen. I used to be so quick at this, but you know what, we're starting back up, so that is okay to be slow. But I'm just gonna take my time with this one, and I kept all my footage in real time instead of speeding it up in like 2x speed or anything. Of course I have cuts where I'm either like fiddling with markers or not really doing anything. In general, I want to show you guys the speed at which I work because it's not very fast, but I feel like because I put out so much content on the internet, people think I work really, really fast when I don't. I think this whole thing probably took me like an hour, maybe? Probably more than that, maybe like an hour and a half. I want to show you guys what it's like when I like actually draw and use my pen and things like that, because things don't come as quickly as I think some people think they do. And so I have everything in real time today just so you guys can kind of see what's going on. Instead of having the eyes be super realistic, I did stylize it a bit. So earlier I spoke about how I did the lashes, and also for the little sparkles in the eyes, I decided to do like this little star shape. I know it might be a little bit hard to see on camera, but like if you zoom in, you can kind of tell what I'm talking about. But I added this little star, and I just thought it was really cute because this is how I draw a lot with like my normal illustrations nowadays. And I just think this like adds a lot of personality, and I think that's something that I want to focus on more instead of just copying photos exactly the way they are, which is how I used to do it. I think my style has changed a lot that I'm ready to start incorporating it into this aspect of my art. So that's really exciting, and that's something that I've been wanting to do for a while, but I just wasn't sure how to do it. But I think everything happens for a reason, and I had to like take this time away from this style to kind of learn more about the other parts of art that I like so that I can come back and merge everything together. That sounds really like poetic and dramatic, but like I think it is true. I used to beat myself up a lot about not doing this anymore because I felt like I was gonna lose my skill. And you know what? I probably am not as good as I used to be, and I probably would be better if I kept doing it at the time. But also, I think there's more to life than realism art, or there's more to art than realism art, and I want to be able to do more things than that. So ultimately, I try not to be upset about taking some time away from this. And I think it all paid off because now I'm able to do more fun things that I enjoy outside of just like being good at it, if that makes sense. Also, now that I'm looking at this footage, it's so awkward how my face is just like on my phone and it's just staring, and the perspective right now makes it look so odd. And so I am doing all of the initial details with this fine liner because I want to make sure that I have everything there. And if I make a mistake with this pen, basically, then I'm able to fix it with a thick marker. And I basically just start from the most like messy and forgiving medium to the most permanent medium. So I start with the pencil because you can erase it, and then the marker because even if you make a mistake, it might blend into the background. The fine liner pen doesn't offer much, but if you do make a mistake, you can kind of outline something better with this thick marker that I'm now using, and it will lend a lot more forgiveness towards the line you just drew. So with this marker, basically whatever line I draw, it's pretty permanent. You can't really go back with it, so it's a little bit nerve-wracking, but I do think that this part also just like adds so much character, so I really like using this marker. This is the Faber-Castell marker, and I use almost only warm tones with these darker colors, so I like using liking the warm grays. I almost never use cool grays just because that's like my personal preference. I just think it looks the best, so that's what I'm using today. My little babies are getting kind of in the way, but that's okay. They like to hang out on my desk, so I let them hang out on my desk. But once I start using this thick marker, it's basically some of the last steps, so I'm just doing some of my finishing touches. I do most of the hair with this because I pay the most attention to the face, and then as it goes outward from there, I don't pay as much attention. So with like the hair and stuff, there's almost no detail because I honestly just like can't be bothered enough to do that. As you can see, I'm not really focused on doing my earrings or my jewelry or anything like that, and I'm just going to outline it with some little liners, and it's gonna look cute. It'll be fine, you know. I try to trust the process. You know what? As much as I want to, I did try to trust the process with the two sketches I was doing before this, and they both were coming out bad. So I'm gonna use the marker and add some little sparkles, another just little personality thing that I've been adding as of late, and I've been using this in like almost all my art, so I'm just kind of transferring some of the newfound things that I like into my realism, and I think that's really fun. I think it's more interesting this way than if I were to just draw it exactly how the picture is. I'm doing some mild shading with the liner, but honestly, I'm still a little bit hesitant on using the micron to shade, which is also something that I used to do a lot, so I'll have to get back into that whenever I'm more comfortable doing that. Part of practicing is just like getting used to the materials and being comfortable with the materials, which is something that I unfortunately have lost. So hopefully once I start sketchbooking again more frequently, I'll be able to gain all of this confidence back and share it with you guys too, because I'm really hoping I can make more sketchbook videos just because I feel like it's also something you guys want to see, right? If you guys enjoy this video, please give this video a like and let me know so that I will be sure to make more of these. I'm about to tape this drawing into my sketchbook where I made the mistakes previously, but you can see kind of what I was doing before, and I didn't show it very much in this video because I am kind of embarrassed that I made a mistake and it like looks so bad. I'm gonna just tape over that mistake with this sheet and no one will ever know, including myself, and I don't have to beat myself up over it. You guys don't have to look at it and we can just pretend like nothing ever happened. But you know, mistakes are normal. Mistakes are very, very normal, and if you're someone who can bear having them in your sketchbook, I think that's great. But if you don't like them, I don't think it should stop you from, you know, trying new things, because you can always cover your mistakes. And you can cover the covers for your mistake too. You can always just keep layering if you like really hate something that you do. So never be afraid to try anything new. But I'm doing this next sketch in a very simple style. I was actually thinking about the composition of this sketchbook layout, which is not something I do very often, but because I am just like doing this for a video, I would like it to look relatively nice. So although I am practicing, I am also going to be focusing on composition a little bit, and I don't want to overpower the sketch on the side because I think that's the most detailed that I can bring myself to do right now. So I am going to just add this little simple one. I colored the skin tone in with pink just so that it has a little bit more contrast, and I'm just gonna go in the liner without any pencil marks and just add the details that way. And I think I'm able to do this because I was gaining a little bit more confidence with the liner with the other sketch, that now I'm able to kind of go in and do this freehand, which is ultimately what I'm trying to get back into because it just makes things so much faster and easier that way as well. So I would love if that could be easier to me. But draw my little facial features. This one is of a mirror picture that I took of myself like a while ago, and we're just going to draw it in. Half my face is like a phone, so it doesn't even really matter if it looks like me or not because most of it is just this phone. But I thought it'd be like a cute little thing to add into the corner. I felt like it was fitting. And I was originally gonna color the whole figure in with pink, and I'm not sure about my decision for just doing the skin tone, but I can always go back in and color the rest of it if I feel like unsatisfied with it, which I think is one of the nicest things about a sketchbook, is that like all of your art is in one place, so you can kind of add onto your older works if you're not like totally happy about them, which is what I find myself doing a lot and why I cover a lot of mistakes all the time. But that's just my personal sketchbook habits, so everyone can do whatever they want. But if you want some advice from me about how to make your sketchbook look like mine, that is what I do, is that I just always go back and add more if I feel like I'm unhappy with something, which is what I did in the beginning of this video when I was adding some of those little stickers to the last entry that I did. Even for something as simple as this sketch, it still takes me a good amount of time, and I just want to show you guys that in real time because I don't want people to feel pressured to like draw really fast. I think it's okay to take your time unless you're on like a time crunch, but if you're just doing this for practice, it's always nice to like slow down and really be mindful of what you're doing. I think speed is something in art that a lot of people really like hold value to, but it's also okay to like slow down and take your time and not be sure of what you're doing. Figure it out as you go. I think that's part of it. It's just like a lot of problem solving and thinking through your intentions. And I just like to take this time. It's kind of like meditative for me because I'm just kind of copying a picture, so I don't have to do too much thinking. And I wanted to add this little background. This is a little heart background backsplash. And I used to add these backsplashes all the time, but they were never hearts. But I've been like weirdly obsessed with hearts lately as like a pattern and an artistic motif for some reason. So I added it to this page and I think it's so, so cute. I also added these bunny ears to myself because I have a gamer chair that has these bunny ears, and sometimes when I stream and when I take pictures of myself, it looks like I have those ears and I think it's really cute. So I was like, you know what? I can just add this like into my drawing because first of all, it's a drawing. I can do whatever I want. And second of all, no one needs to know that I wasn't in my gamer chair when I took this photo, which I was not. But in the rules of art, there are no rules, so I can do whatever I want. I'm adding some other hearts as well just because I think they're really cute, and I love this color of the pink of the Faber-Castell marker. There's actually not a color like this in the Tombow collection, so I would highly recommend this one. I will say though, Faber-Castell does not have as much variety in their markers as I wish they did. I would love if they had like a huge set of way more colors, but that's just my opinion. And since there's a lot of empty space, I decided to just put one of my business cards in here, and I think it's pretty cute. It kind of fits the vibes and it has like hearts and stuff, so I figured why not. Also because at this point I was getting kind of tired and I don't want to draw anymore, so I'm resorting towards stickers to fill in the empty space, which is something that I personally love. I love using stickers to fill in the negative spaces and to also just like add some personality and some sparkle. I love sparkle. And I added some of my Tiffany Weng thank you stickers as well, just because I thought they were like really, really cute and I like the way they look. And lastly, I'm going in with this glitter pen and I'm just adding a lot of sparkle to it. And I wanted to color in my cheeks on this one so that I had like a little bit more personality. So I put little hearts on my cheeks, and if you see this in person, they're really glittery and it's like really pretty. So I really love the way that it came out. And now at this stage, I'm just going to add some more shadows, some more contrast, kind of just tie the pages together and make them look nice. So I'm going in with a light marker and I'm just going to shade in some more parts that I think could have been more contrasted so that you can tell like where the drawing is even if you squint your eyes. Contrast is always really important and something that I really enjoy, so I'm just trying to make sure that there is a lot of that, especially because I put a lot of effort into that one sketch, so I want it to look nice. And the last step I'm gonna do is just add these glittery hearts, which are just some other stickers that I had, and I think they're just so cute. I love glitter, and this is how it turned out.
So that is pretty much how this turned out. I was mostly doing this for practice, so I didn't focus too much on filling empty spaces, but I might go back and add a little bit to this. So when I do the close-ups, it might look a little bit different. But yeah, this was my work for the night. I think it's not too bad. So thank you guys so much for watching and for hanging out. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. I ended up adding a lot of pink to the background. This is pretty much how I wanted it to come out. It's just some practice for me, so I didn't want to do too much. I do still like the other one that I did the other day as well, but I feel like on camera they look super washed out. But it's cute, I swear. But yeah, it's some fun practice. And hopefully I'll be able to make some more of these sketchbook videos because I do want to get back into it, honestly. And I think it's like, it's a really good habit for me to get into. This is what we got for today. We got some like Sailor Moon vibes going on. And I will see you guys in the next episode of whenever I sketchbook again on camera, because for some reason I'm really bad at it. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already, I'd really appreciate it. And the support really helps me out, honestly. So let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. And stay hydrated, take a nap, and I will see you when I see you. Goodbye, everyone!